Well, the first thing I want to say is, I'm immensely pleased to be here with you. And I'm amazed about the level of the pupils. They are not pupils, they are colleagues. Yes? And I share what I know about music with you. But I think you are all, so far as I've seen you now playing this afternoon and the two peoples who I teach this morning, you are exceptional people. How few people can appreciate classical music when you walk on the street? And how many people go somewhere and learn an instrument, play a little bit? And how few people say, it's so beautiful, I want that to be my profession. And you have done that. And I think it's a miracle. When you think what you have to do in order to become a professional, it's immense. It's so much work. Yeah? You have to be talented. And you have to have the feeling, I want to do it. But then you start playing. And you think, music is so beautiful. Well, I can't do what I want. And then tensions creep up. And your body is tense. And your arm hurts or something else hurts. You have so many stages to pass until you become accomplished professional musician who can play relaxed in full possession of his possibilities. It's not so easy as it seems. So I'm full of admiration for all of you, for Michel, for Zion, for everybody. It's just a miracle that we are together here in harmony in music. And tomorrow in the afternoon I will do 2 hours of Mozart. For me, Mozart is perhaps at least one of the greatest composers ever lived. He's a fantastic composer. I will tell you just now a few things about Mozart. But first, I have a few questions. What is music? What is music? You know all what music is. Music is not a sheet of paper with some ink on. You put a matchbox and it has gone. But if you have played it, the music is in your head. What is music? I have no answer. I only know music is something between earth and heaven. Something in between. We are floating when we are playing music. So I think we are absolutely privileged people. Then we all talk about inspiration. When are you inspired? What is inspiration? Where does it come from? I have no answers. I don't know. But we all know what is inspiration. You forget that you exist. You play and you become the music. You are not the musician, you are playing the music. You are the music when you play. You don't exist anymore. You swim in the music and then you play with inspiration. What can you do to get inspiration? Is there something positive we can do to play inspired? And there I have an answer. The answer is, eliminate your ego. Don't want to play. Just play. Don't say, I play this piece. But it happens just that this piece is placed by you. Mm-hmm. Something has happened. You are taken into a maelstrom and you are there and you play. You even don't know that you play. You swim in the music. For me, inspiration is something like that. I tell you now, a personal experience for me. To some people, I might have told it, you know. Because I'm in the very lucky situation never being nervous. It didn't come from alone. This came to me when I was 27 years old. I had a concert, I told you, in Diligentia, in a good, very good chamber music hall in Holland, with the best string quartet of Holland, and I had to play the Mozart clarinet quintet. I played it until now perhaps 150 times in concerts. And everything, I'm just struck by the beauty of the music. And I think everything I play it differently. There, I was nervous. I have to play Mozart with the best string quartet of Holland, in the best chamber music hall of Holland. And I was waiting before I should play, because he played something else before the intermission. And then I had a flash, and I'm so grateful for this flash. This flash was, you don't have to be perfect when you play. You don't have to. Anyhow, we can't be perfect. Yes. When you are perfect, you are a computer who does all the time absolutely the same thing. We are much better than that. Please don't try to be perfect. Just play the music as you feel it, with all the fantasy, and then you're playing inspired. Okay, that is the first part of my speech. I hope you understood all my English. We all have to do that when we make music. Forget ourselves. We are too self-centered. And when you have your education as a conservateur, you have to play very difficult concerts, another difficult concert, the Jean-François concert, the Nielsen, the Boulez, I don't know. And then you have played it, and you work for it. But it's not music. Music is, you forget. In order to get that situation, you have to work very hard, perhaps harder than somebody else, because you have to be able to forget that you play. If you do that, you become the music. It's not so easy. It sounds good, and it's nice to try that. And I invite you all to try that. Seriously, try it. Forget mostly about yourself. We have too much ego. We have greed, we have ego, we have lots of vices. We have also lots of quality. But the main vice for us is ego. And then the Germans always say, play with personality. And they want you to play with ego. I have heard that so many times. And I hated to hear that. I don't want that. I just want the music. Okay, now, that's it. Huh? The second thing I want to say, tomorrow, we are doing some Mozart. We do two trios. The second trio for three basset horns, we play it on two clarinets. And Michel has his basset clarinet. He plays the third part. So the music is absolutely original in that way. And the second thing I absolutely want to do with you is four pieces of the last opera of Mozart, La Clemenza di Tito. But now, with Mozart, you have a problem. Mozart is dead. Many, several hundred years he is dead. When you go back, Second World War, nobody has been in the Second World War. So me, I was born in the Second World War at the end, but I don't remember. No? First World War. You know, the 19th century, things that happened, Wagner, Brahms, and so, I don't know. So far away, what do we know from Mozart? Usually, when we play Mozart, we look back and we say, yes, Mozart is a good composer. I want to play Mozart. Okay. But we forget that in Mozart's time, Mozart was the avant-garde. He was the most modern composer ever lived. That was Mozart. And we have now, when we play Mozart, we have to play Mozart as it is avant-garde music. And there, problems are coming because habits are changing. In Mozart's time, music was mainly a business of aristocratic people. Yes. Well educated, they studied, and was high society. And they played that. Now everybody plays. And this high society who played music had conventions. When you look at the original music of Mozart, there are almost no dynamics in it. There are almost no slurrings in it. Almost nothing is marked. Because at that time, the musicians knew how to play. They were well educated. You do it like that, and then like that, and when it's written like that, you do that. For instance, a semi-quaver, little note, then a quaver and two semi-quavers. Pian tata. Never played that. It is always tia tata. You have to know this kind of habits of that time. But why doesn't he write for a 16th? Because when he writes it like that, a small note, an 8th note, and two 16ths, that means the first note, the small note, has more emphasis. Tia tata. And otherwise it is tia-tata. Tia-tata. So when you see that, you have to change your style. That was something used in that time. Well, I noted something wrong, but I don't want to read so much, I think. there are syncopes. No? There are staccato and sometimes we slur. Now, in my two lessons I had with two of you, mostly you touch the notes with a D. Di, di, da, di, di, something like that. And I think in Mozart's time, it's foundated what I say. I read a lot about it. I read the violin school of Leopold Mozart, the flute school of Quantz, and all what Harnack Kaur ever has written about music. There's a lot of research that's done. So what I say is foundated. It's real, what I say. Yeah? When you start a note, two quarter bar, ti-yam, you never play di-yam, you always play ti-yam. What is the difference between the T and the D? Before the T, there is silence. And before the D, there is D. And the T is T, it's explosive. When you want to start a bar, one, two. One is stronger than the two. La pa pa pa. One and two are stronger than the eight notes that follow. Every note you attack in the music, at least at Mozart's time, should be a T. Always T. Ti ti ra ti ra ta ta ti ti ra. Never ti di ra di ra ta. You hear already when I sing. It's ridiculous to play like that. Ti, ti, ra, ti, ra, ta, ta, ta. Play like that. That's. It's worse to do it. It puts value on the music. Now, there is another thing. In Mozart's time, there were no crescendi. There's one exception. Yeah? There were no crescendo. Now, when you hear a lot of people playing, they play ti, ta, ra, ti, ra, ta, ta. They make a crescendo to the second bar. In a way, it's right. But when you have that, it's loud. There's no nuance mark from Mozart. Probably you have to play it quite loud. No? Every note has a diminuendo. Ti, ti, ya, ti, yam. But then, the way of attacking the note depends on the highs. The first is a sol. The second is a mi. The mi you attack softer than the sol. Then you have an A. And the A you attack louder than the first note, which is a G. Ti, ta, ra, ti, ram, pam, pam, pam. Then you have something. Then the la is on the first, on the beginning of the second bar. You can make it a little bit broader. It's not tim ta ra ti ra ta 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 tim ta ra ti ram pam pam pam. And I sing slow. You understand what I mean, eh?
Yeah.
And that is the way to play this music. There are slurrings in Mozart music. Very few. There are slurrings over the bar line. Syncopes going over the bar line. They are always slurred. A syncope always has an accent stronger than usual. Pam, pim, pam, 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 pam. You have to take time to play a syncope. When you play the syncope too early, pa, 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 you don't have the accent. Pam, pim, pam, 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 pam. You understand what I mean? You can do that slowly, you can do that fast, you can do that at any speed. But you should always play syncopes like that. No? A syncope also is hidden, for instance, in the slow movement of the Mozart concerto. You have a quarter, then you have a quarter with a dot, then you have an eighth note, that is the La. And then the A is repeated on the second bar. And that conditions completely the way you have to play it. When you play ta di 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 pa ri ya ti ya tam. Every quarter in this three-quarter bars has an accent. In principle, every quarter needs a diminuendo. And then it depends on the highs of the note you have. And then the second note is a syncope. You don't have the third bar, the third beat. Parim. It needs. Lam, pi, and then you have the A. which is repeated on the one. When a note is repeated on the one, automatically the accent is stronger. Ti, di, ya, ti, ya, ti. It needs it. When you play like that, you have music. If you don't do it, ta, di, 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 da. So boring to play like that. You understand what I mean? Mm-hmm. And probably this is new for lots of you. But I think it's absolutely essential to play like that, to play music like that. You have remarked when I sing, I don't sing. Yeah, I sing. How much diminuendo you make? It's your choice. You can do much or little, but a little bit of diminuendo you have to do. Otherwise, just the melody doesn't function. It doesn't work. Sing that, yeah. Oh, it's nice. But it makes a diminuendo on every note. Every note has a diminuendo. The only exception for crescendi is chromatic. Mm-hmm. When you have something chromatic. When you play chromatic, it's par definition. Chromatic is out of harmony. You don't know where to go. When the chromatic line goes up, you may make a crescendo in Mozart. But that's so obvious, and they did it. They did it too. When you look at the score of Don Giovanni, at the end, you know the story of Don Giovanni. The commandeur comes, the frightening commandeur, and he'll take Don Giovanni to hell. What does Mozart do? He couldn't write crescendi. He makes one bar, forte, ba, and it is such a frightening effect, so absolutely frightening, so terrible. If you've played on Giovanni, you know what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. Huh? So Mozart had ways to write the music, but all that you don't see in the music. It's not letting in. You have to know that. It was another epoch. You have to study that. You have to learn about that. The best way for you to learn is by the books from Niklaus Harnoncourt. I like him very much, but for me it's a bit of an example. When I was in The Hague, he came and he directed La Création de Haydn, the Schöpfung, the creation of Haydn. And he asked for 13 rehearsals. And we know the piece by heart, because every chorus in the region had sung it. And we went only for the general of the chorus. He started to rehearse that, and the people was bound. They were struck by lightning. The things he said, so beautiful, so exciting, so fantastic. We did a concert with him, and you won't believe it. It is on one of the very best concerts I ever did. And then the people from the Concertgebouw, the best orchestra of Holland, were too. And they watched what happened, and they thought it was so good. They went to Harnoncourt after the concert. They said, "We want you, and we want you exclusively. We give you a contract. You come to West, but never conduct another orchestra in Holland." Well, he did it. He made a lot of money with it. But it's no problem. But you know, it was really an exceptional figure. And at that time, I was busy in learning how to play Mozart. I didn't know what to do with it. I thought, this music is so beautiful. What can I do to do justice to this music? I didn't know. So I went to Harnoncourt. I said, it's so beautiful what you do. May I play Mozart for you? He said, it's not necessary. I watch you. You are a good musician. I will tell you what to do. And he talked to me 2 times in half an hour after the rehearsal. And then I knew. Until today, I know what to do. He explained absolutely everything. It's very, very, very simple. Very simple, just be natural. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. Never. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Measures like that. It's so simple. Then, well, that's about Mozart. I don't want to talk anything more about Mozart, but tomorrow I have the good fortune, it's grace to Dimitri, we can work on 2 pieces of Mozart. But we do the second divertimento. And we do 4 pieces of La Clemenza di Tito. And then we'll see what's going to happen.
We look forward to it, right?
What?
We look forward to it.
This is just a small introduction to that. And during the rehearsal, it's not a jam session then. I might talk, I might stop you and try like this, and I will give some comments. Mostly we play. Yeah? So Michel will play in the trio, and I think I take the third part, at least for two movements, in La Clemenza di Tito. And I hope Dimitri play the last two. And then we need the pupils who want to play that with me.
Yeah.
Okay? You don't need a good technique, nothing. It's easy music. Even when you see a lot of semi-quavers in La Clemenza di Tito, I will explain you La Clemenza. It's a fantastic opera. I think it's perhaps Mozart's best opera. You know the story of it? Okay, no, it doesn't matter so much. But it is two acts. Eh? And after the first act, I saw it for the first time. I think, how possibly can he write another act? Because Titus was murdered by Sextus. Finish! Okay. And Sextus is a woman who sings a man role. She sings a man, and she has a lover, a woman. And that woman makes that Sextus want to kill Titus. And Titus was the best friend of Sextus. But Sextus was enamored, he was in love with the lady. So he tries to kill Titus. If you want to see it, excuse me, I don't want to say all the time the same thing. Try to buy the recording from La Clemenza di Tito with Niklaus Harnoncourt. There is a DVD. Watch that. The singers are exquisite. It's one of the very best performances I've ever seen, I've ever witnessed. Try to buy that. It costs 35 Swiss francs. It's not so expensive. You can afford it. Okay? So now I want to stop, and tomorrow we are going to play. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you.